So you finally did it. 39 straight days at the morgue and you finally took one off. I had to see it for myself.
I was this close to the record.
Well, I thought we could celebrate over breakfast.
This is pathetic. 50 people coming here tonight, and all I have in the way of munchies is the bottle of olives and a box of baking soda.
Now, here's what I don't get. You moved into this place 6 months ago, and you're just getting around to throwing a housewarming party tonight?
What can I say? I've been busy. So, are you nervous?
About what?
Tonight, meeting my friends for the first time, my brother.
All I really do is study my every move and report back to you. Why would that make me nervous?
You'll be great. Hello?
True? Hey, it's me. Oh, come on, it's only been a couple of months. Don't tell me you've already forgotten.
Mark.
Look, I know what happened was my fault, and you have every reason to hate me. But I can't stop thinking about you, True, and I want you back. Hey, are you still there?
Yeah. But now really isn't a good time.
Well, maybe I could come by later. We could talk face to face.
See, here's the thing. What you want really doesn't matter. No, why? Because you're the one who cheated.
Yeah, and it was the biggest mistake of my life, True, and I know that now.
Yeah, well, you should have known it then. Besides, I've met someone new, and he's great.
Please, True. It'll never happen again.
Oh, you're right. It won't.
True.
I gotta go, Mark.
Is everything okay?
Yeah, why?
You looked a little freaked when you answered the phone. I thought maybe it was bad news.
Well, the truth is, that was my ex, and he wanted to see me.
Oh. Well, I can't say that's the answer I was expecting, but, hey, whatever you need. I mean, you know, I've only been out a few times, so...
I told him no.
Even better.
I'm sorry. It's weird. I shouldn't have told you.
No, I'm glad you did. Look, if you and I can't be honest with each other, what hope do we have?
So you're probably wondering why I asked you to meet me here today.
I meet you here all the time.
Whatever. It's Lindsay. Well, ever since we hooked up, I can't stop thinking about her.
You're kidding me, right?
Crazy as it sounds, I'm not. You know me. I can't stand Lindsay. I never could. And yet she just keeps popping into my head. It's confusing the hell out of me.
And you're telling me this now because...
Well, you're meeting her to shop for your party, right? Well, I thought maybe you could feel her out. See where her head's at. You know? Vis-a-vis yours truly.
Yeah.
Oh, come on. Help a brother out. But all I'm looking for is a simple yes or no.
Maybe you're still interested in my brother.
Oh, he's cute, don't get me wrong, but he went all weird after we made out, like he was embarrassed or something, you know, typical guy stuff.
He was probably just nervous.
Still, post hookup, you give a girl a call. You know, maybe send flowers, make the girl feel special.
We don't need that.
Gotta cut the limes with something, right? Besides, it's on sale.
Okay.
Oh my God, Pez. I forgot Pez.
You and your candy.
I just love those little dispensers. They're so kitschy.
Hello, Davis.
So you're absolutely, positively, 100% sure about this whole day off thing?
For the last time, yes.
Okay, but what if a dead body comes in and asks for help? What do I do?
First of all, they don't talk to you. They talk to me.
Okay, but what if...
Second of all, they don't ask for help every night. It's not how it works.
Well, just come in for 5 minutes. If no one asks for help, then you can go home.
Did you hear what I said? I worked 8 days this week, literally.
Yes, but what I'm trying to say is
Davis,
that...
I need a break.
Okay. So I'll see you tomorrow?
I'll see you then. Bye.
Chips, dips, a whole lot of beer. Looks like somebody's having a party. What's wrong?
Nothing. I'm just surprised to see you here is all. No coincidence.
Well, I live 3 blocks from here. Remember that? This is my market where I shop. I'm not following you or anything.
Okay.
Since I have you here, I wanted to apologize because I feel like I came on strong this morning and it was rude.
That's fine.
Anyway, it was nice to see you.
Yeah.
Okay, I still can't believe you had a stalker moment and I missed it.
It wasn't a stalker moment. Mark and I just happened to be in the same place at the same time.
That's what stalkers do. They just happen to be in your market, and then they just happen to follow you home, and then they just happen to chop your head off and seal it in a baggie.
Lens?
I'm just saying. First the phone call, now this.
Hello?
What'd she say? And tell me everything.
Actually, I'm pretty satisfied with my long distance plan.
Well, what the hell is that supposed to mean?
It means you should maybe call back another time.
Oh, she's right there, isn't she?
Yes, that's right. Telemarketer.
Just give me a hint. Tell me something.
Anything.
Well, I think if you want your customer to change plans, you should show her some special consideration.
Special.
Like a gift or something?
Not bad.
Well, what should I get her?
Hey, yeah, she's very happy with the plan she's got now.
Thanks.
Oh.
Only way to handle those guys. God, Marty's like actually on time for once.
Marty, that's who that was.
So can you believe this thing came with instructions?
For a knife?
Yeah, apparently you can cut through rebar.
Good to know.
Oh, God.
Oh.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Hey, Sam.
True. I'm so sorry about the vase.
Oh, don't be. You know what they say? Priceless heirlooms are made to be broken. So, how are you? How's med school? You're at Hopkins, right?
No. I kind of fell through. Yeah, I missed the final because of a big family emergency, and this jerk professor wouldn't give me makeup.
Sorry to hear that.
So now I'm selling shoes with my dad in his store until I could reapply. What about you?
Tagging toes at the morgue.
Man, I thought I had it bad.
Hey. Harrison, it's beautiful.
That's just it's a little something from me to you.
Actually, it's from Builders, Sally.
What?
Yeah, there's an inscription on the back. To Sally from Bill.
Dad, no, that could be removed.
Where'd you get this thing? A pawn shop.
Is that a problem? Happy housewarming.
Thank you. Oh, hey. Come here one sec.
Now, whatever happened to, what is it saying? It's a thought that counts.
It counts if it's yours. This thought here happens to be, Phil's. Oh, hi. You must be Luke. I'm Lindsay.
Nice to meet you.
This is my brother, Harrison.
Hey, how's it going?
True. Hey, can you help me with a punch real quick?
Yeah.
Yo, let me ask you a question, guy to guy. Want to buy a watch? Huh? Hmm?
Okay, your brother is so hopeless. I mean, a pawned watch? How tacky.
Harrison just has his own way of doing things.
Right, the cheap way.
Lindsay!
Okay, sorry. Change of subject. Your new boyfriend is hot.
I just hope he's having a good time.
If he isn't, so what? It's your party, remember?
I've already had a few. I should probably slow down.
Nights like this do not happen that often, especially for someone with a job like yours. Cheers.
Cheers.
Hey, Drew. There's an angry guy at the door. Is this your neighbor? Turn the music down or I'm calling the police.
All you had to do is ask, Brian.
No. I'm not asking, I'm telling. Turn the music down.
Fine.
Yeah, because me and the landlord were like that. Huh? Yeah, one call from me is gonna take away your parking spot.
I don't have a car.
In case you get one.
Why didn't you invite your next door neighbor?
Are you kidding me? That guy's a creep.
All the more reason to invite him. If he's helping make the noise, he can't complain about it, right?
Too late now.
Bye. Hey, bye, you guys. I'll call you, okay?
I need to talk to you. Look, I know that I shouldn't be here. It's inappropriate. But I cannot stay away, and I am sorry.
You need to go now, Mark.
I need you to talk to me, Drew.
We're through talking.
All I am asking for is 5 minutes of your time. 5 minutes, Drew, and then I will go.
Fine, but not here.
Okay. Then meet me upstairs on the roof. Promise me.
Just wait for me there.
Hey, what was that about?
That was the guy who called me this morning.
Your ex?
He just kind of showed up. He wants to talk to me.
So talk to him.
You okay with that?
I trust you.
Thanks. Mark? Oh, what the hell's the matter with you?
So the first time I ever kissed you was on this roof. And I thought maybe...
Mark.
No, stay. Talk to me about how great we are together.
You need to go home. Don't come near me again. Call you a cab, Sam?
No, but if you know of a good place to throw up, that would be great.
Down the steps, took a right. Anywhere in the alley's fine.
You rock.
You okay?
Yeah, where'd everybody go?
Well, without you here, no one really felt like partying. That, and we ran out of booze. Was everything okay with the party crasher?
Fine.
I'm tired.
Lindsay's punch kind of got my dad doing somersaults.
So go to bed. I'll clean up after you.
No, no, just leave it till tomorrow.
Come on. Let's get you to bed.
Thanks for everything. I had such a good time tonight.
Yeah, me too.
You want to stay?
I would love to, but tonight you need to sleep.
So I'll see you tomorrow.
Count on it. Good night.
I thought you said you were going home.
Finally did it. 39 straight days at the morgue and you finally took one off. I had to see it for myself. So here's what I don't get. You moved into this place 6 months ago and you're just getting around to throwing a housewarming party tonight? True.
Sorry, what's that? Hello?
True? It's me.
Mark.
Yeah, you haven't forgotten. I'm glad.
There's something that I'd like to talk to you about, but I don't want to talk to you over the phone.
Standard diner, 1 hour.
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
That was Davis. He needs me to work today.
You're kidding. Well, can I wait until after breakfast?
He said it was an emergency. Look, you're not mad, are you?
No, I feel bad for you. Seems like you never catch a break.
I'll see you tonight, right?
Yeah.
When I turned him over, there was a single wound right below the heart. I called 911, but then he asked for help, and the day restarted, and here I am.
So if I'm to understand you correctly, you had a party and didn't invite me.
Davis.
I thought we were friends.
We are friends.
Yeah, sure, when you wake up next to some dead guy.
I apologize. Can we please focus here?
Okay. So you have no idea how Mike ended up in your bed?
Mark, no, I don't. Look, I had a lot to drink last night.
What about suspects?
So far, I can only think of one.
Who?
Me.
Come on, True.
Well, I don't know. Mark was acting so weird yesterday. Maybe he got violent. Maybe I fought back.
There's no way did you kill him.
How do you know?
Because I know you. You save lives. You don't take them. So the victim was stabbed once in the chest. Was that the only wound?
There was a pretty deep cut in the palm of his right hand.
What else?
there was blood on the wall behind my bed. It looked like sort of a half circle.
Interesting. Anyplace else?
I just woke up and he was here. I don't know how. Yeah, on the doorknob.
And you said you found the knife on the floor?
Beside the bed. Only the first couple inches of the blade were bloody.
That indicates a shallow wound.
You don't think it was suicide?
No, the slash on his palm sounds like a defense wound, meaning he was trying to protect himself, which suggests murder. Here, let me show you something. It's a forensic simulator program. It helps investigators recreate a crime scene that has been tampered with or destroyed.
So you're gonna recreate my apartment on the computer?
Once I put in these variables, I might be able to extrapolate some ballpark description of the killer.
How ballpark?
Height, weight, sex. It'll take a few hours.
Well, I'm meeting Mark in 15 minutes.
Aren't you forgetting something? The party I'm invited tonight, right?
There isn't gonna be a party.
Oh no, there has to be a party. There has to be a party. In order to save Mark's life, you have to recreate the circumstances that led to his death exactly. Not only can you not cancel the party, you have to make absolutely sure that he shows up. Otherwise, the killer could strike some other place. Some place where you will not be able to protect him.
All right. Sorry, Harrison. We'll do lunch tomorrow.
Actually, there was something I needed to talk to you about.
Lindsay, right?
Yeah.
How did you?
Look, if you want her to like me, you gotta make her feel special.
Well, how do I do that?
I don't know. Pick some flowers or burn her a CD mix.
Well, could I just go buy her something?
Fine. Just make sure it's not a watch with another woman's name on it.
Oh, come on. I would never do that. Unless I did that. Did I do that?
I thought you don't believe that I relive days.
I don't. I mean, look, I'd like to. I would. But don't change the subject.
All I wanted was some advice.
Okay, then just remember, think personal, not personalized.
It's been a while, huh? You okay? You seem a little...
Yeah, it's nothing. I'm fine.
It's kind of strange seeing me, isn't it?
Kinda.
Yeah. Anyway, the reason I called...
Yeah, what's been going on with you?
Me? You know, the usual. Just classes, grading papers, praying for tenure.
What else? Personally?
I was seeing somebody. But I broke it off, if that's what you mean.
Another student?
Yeah. It's not one of my best qualities, is it?
Anyone I know?
Gotta admit, True, this isn't the conversation that I thought we'd be having. Her name is Julie Spence. She graduated last spring, and now she works in the mayor's office.
How'd she take it?
Take what?
The breakup.
Actually, she kind of went psycho on me, and she even slashed my tires the night I broke things off with her. But you don't want to hear about this. This is really good to see you again, True.
Yeah, you too.
Well, this is great. It was strange, but it was great.
Yeah, it was good to see you.
You know, we talked so much during lunch, I never got to... tell you why I call. I've been thinking about you a lot, True. About us, about how great we were together. And I miss you so much. I want you back.
Mark.
No, look, I know that we have a lot to work out, but I will do whatever it takes.
I'm seeing someone. And I know how this is gonna sound, but I want us to stay friends.
Friends. Yes. I've heard that one before.
No, really. Hey, I'm having a party tonight. You should come. We could talk some more, you know, about everything.
Okay. That sounds great. I have a late class, but I'll swing by right after.
Okay.
Okay. Bye.
Bye.
I guess Davis didn't need you after all.
What are you doing here?
I'm on my way to work, which, by the way, is where you're supposed to be.
Look, the guy you just saw me with is my ex-boyfriend. He's the one that called this morning.
That's why you ran out on breakfast? So you could meet him?
Luke, he's in trouble. He needed to talk to me.
What kind of trouble?
It's hard to explain. You just have to trust me.
Like I trusted you when you said you had to work this morning. You know what? Have fun at your party tonight. All right?
Luke, wait, Luke! You called me here to look at a watermelon? How's that supposed to help us solve a murder?
Observe. Notice there's no leakage. The knife has sealed the wound, but when you pull the knife out, does that look familiar?
So you're saying Mark pulled the knife out himself?
But that's not all. The blood on the doorknob suggests that he opened the door with his wounded hand, indicating that he was stabbed outside of your apartment. Okay, here's the sequence of events as I see them. Mark Evans is attacked. Left there for dead, he gets to his feet. He staggers towards your apartment. With his wounded hand, he opens the door. Makes his way to the foot of the bed. Places his hand on the knife.
And yanks it out of his own chest.
Precisely.
Yeah, but how is he supposed to just walk around with a knife in his heart?
Because the knife sealed the wound. For the first few minutes, there was probably very little blood loss.
Then why pull it out?
Well, more than likely, he was in shock. And I know what you're thinking. None of this proves that you're the killer.
Yeah, well, none of this proves that I'm not the killer either. You know what I was supposed to be doing right now? Making bean dip, decorating for my party, having fun.
Nobody said this job was gonna be easy.
You know, no one said it was gonna suck either.
True, true. You're not alone. We are gonna crack this together.
Turn the music down or I'm calling the police.
Hey, Brian, I'm having a party tonight and I'd like you to come.
Seriously?
Yeah. What fun would it be without my neighbors?
All right.
See you tonight?
Sure, yeah. I mean, I'm always up for a party.
Great. Right. Julie Spence.
What the hell?
Oh.
Hey,
True, a little help here.
Ever heard of two trips?
Well, someone hadn't bailed on me.
Sorry about that. How much do I owe you?
$140 plus change. Oh, don't look at me like that. It was on sale. Whoa. Okay.
You made me come all the way over here to get rid of a knife. A perfectly good knife, I might add.
Just lose it. I don't care how.
Oh, hey. So I still haven't figured out a gift for Lindsay. I mean, any other chick, I'd buy like candles or something. But with Lindsay, she's got such weird taste.
So get her something weird. Just make sure.
I know. Get rid of the knife. Something weird.
Excuse me, Julie.
Hi. You don't know me. My name's True Davies. I'm a friend of Mark Evans.
Actually, I know exactly who you are. Mark used to talk about you all the time.
He did?
He was obsessed with you, even when he and I were together. You here to gloat?
About what?
Getting him back. I always knew he wasn't over you.
I didn't get him back. I don't even want him back.
Then what do you want?
to warn you. No matter how strong your feelings are for Mark, you can't let them get the best of you.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
He told me you slashed his tires the night he called things off.
No, it wasn't me. But whoever did that terrible thing, I'm sure Mark deserved it.
Just stay away from him.
What are you, his bodyguard?
No, I'm just worried about him, that's all.
Look, whatever happened between me and Mark is our business, and not yours.
I'm not so sure about that.
I'll deal with my exes my way, true?
Yeah, that's what I'm worried about.
You know what? I think I finally get why you and Mark were so perfect together. You're both psychotic.
Come in.
Hey.
Hey.
Thought I might find you in here.
Yeah, photographer in a dark room. Go figure.
I'm sorry I lied. I only met Mark because I was worried about him. It won't happen again.
Yeah, you know, the first time we went out, you warned me there'd be times you'd take off with no explanation. And before today, I was okay with that. But now I'm curious, when you leave, where do you go?
Luke.
Come on. I mean, you said you were gonna be honest with me.
And I will.
So tell me, what's the deal? Do you have some secret life? Another guy stashed somewhere?
Of course not.
Then why won't you tell me what's going on with you? All right. Honesty.
Hey, Luke.
It's okay. Because we were just starting, and it's better this happened now instead of later.
Listen, if you're looking for neat and easy, then yeah, you're probably right. You've got the wrong girl. But if you think you can handle something a little more complicated, then stick around. You won't be sorry.
Yeah.
Hello?
I need to see you now.
I've got to go. Davis needs me.
Yeah. Heard that before.
I finished running the numbers through the simulator.
And?
Well, based on the victim's own height and weight, as well as the location and moderate depth of the wounds, I believe that the killer was approximately 5'4", right-handed, and lacking upper body strength. Most likely a female. What do you think?
I think you just described me.
Don't go putting words in my mouth. I still don't think you did it.
5'4", right-handed, my apartment, my knife. Who else could...
I'll deal with my exes my way, true.
Julie.
Who?
Mark's ex-girlfriend, she and I are about the same size.
Well, there you go. Now all we have to do is go to the party, keep an eye on Mark, and if the ex shows up, you and I will be there to stop her.
And if I'm the killer?
I will not let you make the same mistake twice.
Thanks, Marty. Glad you can make it.
Hey, neighbor. Kickin' party.
Thanks, neighbor.
You okay? You look a little worried.
The last party I had was kind of a disaster.
Oh. Before I moved in, I guess. It's okay. Don't worry about it. If things start to slow down, I'll go get my karaoke machine. People love that stuff.
So, here's a little something from me to you. I know you got like a ton, but this one's supposed to be pretty rare.
Oh my God. Popeye, 1952. Blue base, no feet. There's only like 2,000 of these made. How did you know?
Well, you said something about a collection once. I guess I wanted you to know that I was listening.
Look what your brother gave me.
Sorry, he means well.
Are you kidding? I love it.
You do?
Yeah, I don't know. I'm thinking maybe I was wrong about him. Maybe he is special.
You haven't seen Mark, have you?
As in your ex? Why would he be here?
I invited him.
What? Why would you do that? What about Luke?
It's a long story.
Okay, you know what you need? Some of my special punch.
Thanks, but not tonight. Hi.
How's it going?
No sign of Mark or Julie yet, but it's still early. Glad you're here.
Oh, thanks for having me. Where should I stand?
Bought. Need some? Because if you do, you know, I live just right next door.
Got a knife?
Well, now I'm selling shoes with my dad in his store until I can reapply. How about you?
Could you just excuse me one sec?
Yeah, no problem.
Where'd you get that?
Your neighbor. I can't find the one I bought today. Have you seen it?
No, just be careful, okay?
Okay.
Sis, you got a sec? So, I don't think it's gonna happen for me and Linz.
But she loved your present.
Yeah, but she's so into me now. It's sort of a turnoff. You mind if I turn on the TV, check out some scores?
Yeah, whatever.
Okay.
Hey.
You made it.
Yeah. Sorry I'm late. My class ran kind of long.
Not a problem. I'm just glad you're here.
Yeah, me too. Hey, do you have a second?
Sure.
Hey, it's kind of loud in here. Do you think we can go to the roof?
I'm the hostess. I shouldn't.
Come on. I'll take a second.
So I thought you had a boyfriend. What happened? Did he go missing? Or...
No, he's not here.
Trouble in paradise?
Something like that.
Oh, trust me. He is a fool to walk away from a girl like you. Take it from someone who knows.
Thanks. What are you doing?
I'm sorry. You invited me to the party.
Mark,
and
I told you. I just want to be friends.
Hey, but friends isn't enough. I won't give you up, True.
You don't have to. Maybe he got violent. Maybe I fought back. Look, just stay away from me, Mark. For your own good.
True.
Downstairs, hook a right, anywhere in the alley.
You rock.
So your brother took off on me.
You're kidding.
Yeah, he said something about a card game downtown and then you just split. Can you believe that?
What's that for?
Your bae's. Sam knocked it over.
Oh, I shouldn't have let him drink so much tonight.
It wasn't really a drunk thing. It was more like an angry thing.
What do you mean?
He got all worked up over some professor that screwed him over, cost him a slot in med school.
This jerk professor wouldn't give me makeup. The killer is approximately 5'4", right-handed.
Meet me upstairs, then, on the roof.
Sam.
Prestigious medical school in this entire country, and they wanted me.
Sam, I'll make a telephone call.
No,
and explain what happened.
No, come on, it's too late for that now. It took me months, but I was finally getting my life back together, and you just go and show up at my friend's party. I just knew I couldn't let it go this time. I couldn't let it go.
Put it down, Sam.
Drew, this is the guy. This is the guy that I was telling you about.
You're drunk. You don't want to do this.
Well, I had a plan. I had one chance to. And he took it from me.
So take it back.
What are you talking about?
You don't like the way things went down the first time? Do something about it.
I am!
No, you're giving up. You hurt Mark. Your life actually becomes the sob story you think it is. You get to spend the next 20 years in a cell feeling sorry for yourself. Is that what you really want?
God!
True. I don't know how to thank you.
You can say goodbye.
Ex-student with a carving knife on the roof. Simulator would have never figured that one out.
I still don't get how Mark made it all the way back down here with a knife in his chest.
Well, he loved you, Drew. That always makes a person stronger.
Hey. Hope I'm not too late.
You know what? I'll just see you guys at work.
Thanks, T.
So, I've been thinking.
About?
And nothing good comes easy. If I need to work a little harder to keep you in my life, then so be it. I have a feeling you're worth it.
Well, what about when I take off? Think you can handle it?
I guess we'll find out. Sorry I missed your party.
Well, it's not over yet.
No.
No. Not tonight.